Trump has arrived in Scotland to talk about his plans for what he claims will be the world's greatest golf course.
And it's going to be done environmentally perfect.
Donald Trump, poznati američki milijarder koji želi sagraditi golfski teren ovdje u škotskom Aberdeenu. No grupa škotskih vlasnika kuća mu se suprotstavlja kad tajkun započne pripreme za uništavanje posljednjeg nedirnutog britanskog priobalja da bi napravio luksuzno golf odmaralište. Dok lokalno stanovništvo zauzima posljednje uporište usprkos pravnim prijetnjama i isključenjima vode i struje, redatelj Anthony Baxter završava u zatvoru dok traga za istinom. Od toga nastaje dokumentarac Na samareni ste ili You've Been Trumped, a njegov autor sličnu priču koja je dobila više međunarodnih nagrada želi napraviti i o golfu na Srđu iznad Dubrovnika.
Can you compare a project in Scotland with this one on Srđu?
I was very struck by the similarities between the two stories. In Dubrovnik there is Mount Srđ, which is a wilderness area and probably the last part near the city that could be developed. And in Scotland what we had was a wilderness area, a sand dune system, and a number of people who were holding out against the developers, saying we didn't want to see this golf course resort. 1,500 houses and a multi-level hotel were proposed in Scotland. And here it's a similar kind of plan, and there are the same sort of debates. I think the interesting thing here in Dubrovnik, though, what we've seen with the signature campaign is the way people have said, I want a voice on this, I want to be heard, and I want my voice to be heard. And that's what's really struck me this last week in a very inspiring way from the people here.
That's not the point in Scotland.
No, I think what happened in Scotland was the media locally just didn't report the full impact that this resort was going to have, particularly on the environmental front. I mean, it was going to be built on a site of special scientific interest, which is the highest accolade that our country can bestow to a protected site. But the Scottish Government threw out its own rule book and said that's okay to develop on here because it's going to bring 6,000 jobs. And that was the message that the local people and across Scotland had heard, that it was going to be economically very, very important to Scotland. But as you see in the film, the truth is somewhat different to that. I mean, the London School of Economics pored over the figures that Donald Trump had given to the Scottish government and said they simply don't add up. There aren't going to be all those jobs. And so until the film came out, people hadn't seen that side of the story. And I think that that is how only now are we seeing people saying, hang on a second, we didn't know the truth.
People love what we're doing. They love the fact that I'm creating a lot of jobs.
They're not going to be creating jobs in the local economy.
People of Bosanka, the village on Srđ, hope that the investors will resolve their infrastructural problems. What do you think? Is that true?
Well, it's difficult to tell at the moment. I mean, I was at Bosanka yesterday speaking to one local resident who is fully in favour of the development and has very few concerns about the environmental impact. He was saying that he thinks that the government will keep a watch on that. Another resident I spoke to who has a house there was saying that he fears the opposite, that essentially there won't be anybody keeping a watch. Water, a big golf course, and how do you keep that irrigated? And where does that supply come from? What effect do the chemicals that you have to have on a golf course have on this incredibly important rock, which is, it seems to me, a lot of questions that aren't answered. And I think that probably people will want those answers if the development ever goes ahead.
Yeah, but how many new working places are open in that golf resort in Scotland?
Well, the jobs that were promised were 6,000, and the number of actual jobs is closer to a few dozen. So that's jobs like mixing drinks in the clubhouse, mowing the grass, and these are not the sort of the high pay jobs that I think people were expecting to be created.
What are your opinion? The worst consequences of golf resort in Srđ.
This is the last area that can be developed, and there should be real sensitivities in the planning for that, because it shouldn't be an area which is a gated community and essentially only open to wealthy people. It has to be, if it is going to be developed, something which the whole town can enjoy. I think the other points that have been made is obviously it's a very sensitive area. I mean, this is a place where people lost their lives only in 1991 in the war. If you develop that stretch of land, it has to be done in a very, very sensitive way to the memory of those people. The problem is, if you develop and you put up a hotel and lots of villas that are essentially only for, you know, wealthy people, that once that is done, it's done, and you can't undo the damage. You can't turn back the clock, and that's what's happened in Scotland.
My hair okay? The greatest thing I've ever done for the environment is what I'll be doing right here in Aberdeen.
You said you talked with many locals, but you wanted to talk with Mayor. Why didn't you?
Well, I did approach the mayor, and I will hopefully do an interview with the mayor, Dubrovnik. The original plan I had was to interview him this week, but unfortunately he's not in town, and it seems that trip has been extended. The story here in Dubrovnik is one I think that will resonate with people everywhere, not only in Croatia, but also elsewhere in Europe. I think what is of real significance that I've been documenting over the last couple of weeks is the move to bring all these signatures to spark a referendum on the whole question of whether the town of Dubrovnik wants this golf course. And what we've seen is an astonishing turnout of people. You know, over 8,000 people have put their names to wanting to have a referendum and wanting to have their voices heard. And we all know that all over the world, it's very difficult to get people to come out to vote in elections. And I think it's something that people all over the world will understand as being a very important moment for democracy and for ordinary people to have their voices heard.